8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Everybody, let's go.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this first round of all this Hot Rod National season that we've got on the Assetto Corsa. It's a brand new one and it's going to be definitely action-packed. With me tonight here, we've got Tommy Leary. Good evening, Tommy. How are you?
Good evening, Charles. I'm doing well, thanks. And you?
It sometimes can be better, but most of the times it's good, so we can't complain. But yeah, first stream for this year for us, I think for you and me together at least. And yeah, let's hope this one goes well. I mean, like we said to you guys before, this is now our Sim Race African National Oval Tour 2021. And Tommy, quite a bit of prize money for this one.
Yeah, there is quite a bit of prize money. We have a couple of big sponsors that is actually up for us to this evening. Well, not this evening, but for this league, we've got a couple of big sponsors that threw in quite a few bucks. One of them is, who's all the sponsors, Charles? I'm not sure. I actually need to get my things here.
They've got a big sponsor on our side, and yeah, so we do say thanks for those guys. And I think we've got about 8,000 in total that is open up to all the grabs, winners of this league. And talking about it, look at this Fiesta of Donny, number 47 himself. What a nice little car this is, and I think Peter has outdone him again on this design of this car.
Yes, he definitely has, especially on all of them. I mean, you've got the Tigra, you've got the Corsa, you've got Donny's Fiesta that he was specially built for Donny, and then you've got a few others as well. But with the tracks that he did, with the cars that he did, he definitely outdone himself on this as well for this league.
Yeah, it's really blessed to have somebody like this in Sim Race Africa. And you know, if you put everybody's talents together, a little bit goes a long way. And yeah, from Warwick in the background running the servers, Melvin that's constantly changing our Discord server and updating it for the guys, and just to be more user active as well, user friendly. So yeah, it's yourself and your designs, and Jay that's always Jay, I think, is there to keep us straight and narrow.
Well, not that much straight and narrow. I mean, he's like the little black sheep. He's the naughty one, as we call it, although he's the most innocent one. But hey, someone has to take the title, eh?
Free practice, we've got about 5 minutes to go on this one to tell the guys at home how will our evening works. Is basically we will have two qualifying rounds running, then out of the qualifying we will set your times. We will split you into your heats. We will run four heats. Those heats will determine who will be in our two finals. So the slower, well, you can say slower, but if you look at these times, it's 0.5 seconds from each other, so I don't think you're slow here. But the slower guys will get into final two, and then, or final one, and then final two will be, rather they say, the faster of the faster guys. So I think we, as we like to call it, is maybe just doing a plate final and then the final at the end of the day. So it's going to be an action-packed evening, and yeah, to keep it up. And hey, look at this, I just looked at the stream now, we've got Donny van Rooyen, as we mentioned, from Maximum Effort Custom Accessories, And yeah, he's in 181 Industrial, Slathcombe Street, shop number 2. So join him there on his Facebook page and support all of our guys that making life for us possible as well.
Yeah, no, definitely. I mean, the guys put in a lot of effort, they put in a lot of time, and to be honest, they invest a lot of money into the online simulation racing the last few months, or almost a year now since I've been part of the group. And the guys really go out of their way and really do a lot for us. So please, guys, help out, sponsor, or support the people, the local businesses that is advertised here and that helps and supports us in our sim racing.
Yeah, definitely, Tommy. And like you say, I mean, we say that these guys have spent a lot of money, but you don't need to spend a lot of money to actually start sim racing. Sim racing can get done on the cheap. I mean, we've seen this week there was some sim racing steering wheels and pedals being sold for something going for 2,500 rand. So you can get 2,500 rand, some antique chairs and a desk, and you can actually get racing.
Yeah, no, definitely. Anyone can start off in the cheap. I mean, if I look at myself, the most expensive thing for me was basically my wheel, but I could not get a second-hand one at the time, so I had to buy a new one. But the rig itself and what you used to race with, you can build it out of wood, you can build it out of metal, you can buy one. There's a whole bunch of options. So if you have the money, there's a whole bunch of guys that makes it and sells it on the on our Discord page, Facebook page, and part of our group. Or if you can and you have the knowledge and the means to do it, then you're welcome to build it yourself. So if you do it yourself, it can be a lot cheaper. If you obviously have to buy something, then it can be more expensive. But even then, you don't need to go and spend 80,000 rand on it. I mean, you can start off under 10,000 rand. It's really not that expensive.
Yeah, no, it is. And I've always liked, there were some nice PVC rigs that you could actually build, and I've always had my eye on those. And like you say, you can, but you know, Tommy, we're saying about rigs and TVs and VR and all these different kind of things, but funny enough, some of the guys that, as you like to call them, aliens, they are actually super fast driving on a normal kitchen table desk or a dining room desk and a normal office chair. So it's not necessarily the best of the best of equipment and where you are. So yeah, at the end of the day, is you just gotta have fun.
It's true what you say. I mean, you can sit at a normal desk with a steering wheel and a normal dining room chair, and you can be way up front racing with the fastest guys. It's based on talent, not just the equipment that you use. It's the same as in real life. You can spend R500,000 on a car and not know how to drive it, and you'll be dead lost. Or you can spend 15,000 on a car and you'll be up front. It depends on your driving skills and your driving abilities.
That is so true, because it doesn't matter how much money I've thrown to some racing, I'm still a back-ender. I cannot get faster. And it's
sure,
your driving.
I agree on that one with you, but same on this side. I mean, it's the struggle is real.
Yeah, but yeah, it happens. 24 seconds to go, Tommy. If I look at the times now, we've got in first place in this practice round, so to speak, we've got Donnie van Rooyen at 14.45. Blake is now in a good old second and 14.59. So those guys are right on top of each other's bumpers. Konrad van Rensburg, 14.7. Dennis Kutzer in 14.8. Jason Craig in 14.9. So we've got 14, 4, 5, 7s, 8s, and 9s. And then Harnes Basson just jumped in at a 14.9 as well. If this is the case, it's going to be either chaos or it's going to be some very close racing, Tommy.
Definitely, I have to agree with you on that one. Charles, I'm getting some notifications that the voices are quite soft on the stream. Did you push up the volume a bit there?
We are doing it as we speak. I've got also guys giving us feedback because, like I said, this is our first stream and we have changed some of our hardware. So none of the mics are the same that it used to be. So we're going to keep on adjusting. And you guys will see it will get better in the next 2 minutes, I promise you. But with that, quickly, let's go. And as I like to call it, this oval league is definitely something to rumble about. So Tommy, have a look at this nice intro to our oval league.
Go for it, Charles.
Three, two, one.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get her ready to rumble!
Guys, we're back now, and with us, we've just called in one of our founders, Mr. Melvin Gose, with us. Melvin, good evening.
Hey, Charles, not sure what the sound is like, but yeah, nice to be here.
Perfect. Melvin, from SRA site, what is the upcoming leagues that we're currently running, and how can the guys get to us?
Well, Charles, they can connect either with Discord or Facebook via SimRace Africa, and... couple of big things happening. Up and coming, we are busy developing. As you know, we've got one of the best modders in sim racing, and he has done a couple of South African tracks. Currently, I think the biggest thing that is going to happen this year on SRA is we have bought a 3D model of the brand new Polo, and we're going to do a brand new Polo Cup, which was a huge success last year. And then we are also doing, for those of the guys that knows the South African racing series very well, we're going to do a full-on V8 Mastercard in the Ford Mustangs, fiberglass bodies, all Mustangs, and also the Makita Power Cars, which are Opel Astra fiberglass bodies as well, sort of a space frame car. So that's the three big things that we're looking forward to this year.
Yeah, definitely. And I must say to you guys, the Ginetta Super Cup that is currently on or was is an amazing car to drive. I absolutely loved that car.
Yeah, the Ginetta is, I mean, everybody loves it. It's such a nice handling car. It hasn't got too much power, and everybody loves to drive the car. So that's a series that we, again, didn't expect to be as big as it is, and every race we get full grits. So yeah, should be a good one to watch.
Definitely. But Melvin, anything else? SimRace Africa, growing, current membership?
Current membership, I think on Facebook we're about 500 members strong. On the Discord side, 300. You get the guys that prefer where they want to race and what they do. If I see the guys line up, I think I'm going to leave you to it. And if they want to get involved, just search SimRace Africa on Facebook or Discord.
Definitely. Thanks, Melvin. And we'll look forward to speaking to you a little bit later.
Coleman.
Awesome. Tommy, we've got about 2 minutes to go, or 1.5 almost minutes to go to this race, and this is qualifying one. Take us through, who's our drivers for this evening? Quali one.
Well, in this quali one, we've got Blake Krieger, we've got Conrad, Jansen van Rensberg, Donny van Rooyen, Dennis Krieger, Jason Loosmoor, Leandre Sparks, Martin Meinkies, Pieter Geldenhuys, Pieter Grobler, Rowan Power and Warwick Stewart. Now to get back to that, we've actually got SRA 1 and SRA 3, which means they are our top driver and third top driver in SRA for last year, which is Pieter Geldenhuys, who are SRA 1, and Pieter Grobler, who are SRA 3.
I see Pieter Geldenhuys is actually off track now. He's starting on the south side of this oval track, so I'm not sure if that is a slight glitch or they're actually doing a split start if I look at it like this. But for those at home that do not know, we are racing tonight in Windhoek, Namibia, in the Tony Rust Oval Track. And those of you that ever had the privilege to meet Mr. Rust himself, he's a true gentleman and an icon in this pioneering motorsport in Namibia. And it's a hell of a big racing family. In overall, but talking about families, you guys, Tommy, you're a big racing family as well.
Yeah, we are quite a big racing family. I mean, my dad used to race, well, it's quite a few years ago, I think it's about 20 odd years ago that he used to race. And then my stepfather still races every now and then, as well as my mother, and then my brother as well. So yeah, we're quite a big racing family. I'm the only one that actually does sim racing, where they are more the people that actually does it in real life.
All right, Tommy, now we've got lights there, is just lined up, and I can see right in the back, as we predicted, you will see Pieter Geldenhuys, and I'm not sure, that's Blake Krieger, that's just joined us for this race start. So it has been a split race. Let me just jump to the pits here. We do not want a Ford Transit taking over these Rotaries, Tigras and Fiestas for this race. But anyway, there we go now. We're going to do a countdown race. And let's see who's going to take it off. Who's going to have your money, Tommy?
Well, I don't want to be a commentator's curse, but I actually do have to put my money on Donny. He's super fast. And I mean, that Fiesta is just something else.
Perfectly. Well, Donny, sorry for chipping in, but Donny has done 4,500 laps on this track in the last week.
Holy hell. He's got to be fast. But now as we go, we can see right on the lead, Donny van Rooyen has taken this with a 0.8, already a second leap onto Jason Loosmoor. Jason is also gaining up quite fast. Pieter Grobler in third position. And then we've got Rowan Bauer that's also making his presence known tonight. And I think Rowan is one of our new drivers. He's the first time I think I see him in this Oval Tour League. So it's lucky to see these guys competing. And Pieter Geldenhuys is taking up at the back now. And Dennis Knutse is also right in that battle.
Yeah, definitely you're going to get some close racing through you tonight. I mean, you've got your faster guys up front, and then you've got your bit slower guys down at the back. But even up front or midfield or at the back of the pack, there's going to be quite a few close dices. Maybe here and there a bit of rubbing, but let's hope no major incidents.
Yeah, we've got already battle starting to brew with Donny and Jason that's attacking each other. And then we've got another battle like a mid-pack with Rowan and Pieter Grobler. And then we've got the third back with Conrad and Dennis. So I think these guys are they're literally dicing 2-2-2 in a pack. And I think they are sussing each other out and just trying to find each other where they are for this next. Because remember, this is only qualifying. And this will dictate where you start in the heat. So there's no real pressure here, Tommy. There's no real pressure here. It's only trying to finish the race and score those points.
Yeah, no, it is true, but the better you do in your points, obviously the higher up you will be in your division to do your actual race. But so it's overall, there is going to be a bit of dicing and fighting for position.
And then also for the guys that are home now, our point scoring basically works in the heats that we run 10 guys in a race, and then we start off first position will get 10 points, and then it works its way down to 10th position that will only get 1 point. So yeah, in the heat you wouldn't try and rack up those points to get you into that plate or that final now. But as we see, Tommy, 2 laps to go already. How fast is oval track in Tony Rust tonight? 10.1 laps. Donny van Rooyen still leading the pack here, 2 seconds now onto Jason, and Jason has just started losing time crazy to Donny, because now he's already almost down on 2 seconds. Rowan Bowers also still in the battle. He's now gained, and he's taking Jason, and he's smelling that methanol coming out of that rotary engine there at the back. Peter Grobler just slightly falling back, but I think he's just conserving that Corsa for the next races. And then we've got Conrad Dennis, and there's a lacquer battle brewing here between Peter and... it's actually not. It's Dennis being overtaken. But that was it. Tommy, final race over. Quick 12 laps. Donny van Rooyen takes his pole position. Jason Losmer in second. Rowan third. Peter Grobler fourth. Conrad in fifth. Dennis is sixth. And then we've got Peter Geldenhuys that racks up there in eighth position. What a quick race.
Yeah, no, definitely. It's something to get used to. I mean, we used to taking 1 minute, 2 minutes per lap. Now it's like 2 minutes for a race. It's something to get different to. Although I just have to mention that in these races between heats, we need to jump between the servers to have the correct people on the track. So if there is a little bit of downtime between the races, just bear with us. It's only a few seconds.
Yeah, and we do obviously also have, we rely on the internet and all that, and our servers are sitting way down in Durban with Warwick manning that. So sometimes we just cannot get it up in the 10 or 20 seconds we need. And then we you guys will have to listen to Tommy Leary's beautiful voice a little bit longer. We can't say the same for Melbourne Coast.
Yeah, well, I'm not going to say anything. It's not going to come out nice. I'm going to grab Don on Ineos. First race with Fiesta. He has been looking forward to this. So let's quickly drop him in here, see what he has to say. Donny, can you hear us?
Hello.
Hi, yes, Donny.
Well, you're in chat with us, and we're watching that Fiesta just seems, I mean, 4,500 laps on practice. You've got it dialed in there, bud.
Yeah, I mean, Peter worked hard on this car, and now it's starting to pay off.
Yeah, we can see it's definitely paying off on the track.
Donny, from my side, a little bit about your company. I see you do custom accessories. Tell us a little bit, where are you guys based?
We're based in Pretoria, Hermanstad. We manufacture these replacement 4x4 bumpers and rock sliders and cattle rails.
I need to come visit you because I've got a Land Rover Discovery 4 that my wife drives, so maybe I definitely need to make a turn this week by you.
We'll help you gladly.
Perfect. But Donny, thanks for everything. We do appreciate you and the support you've given us and everybody at home as well. And good luck for the rest of the evening.
Thank you. It's just a pleasure. Eh?
Pleasure, Donny.
Enjoy, buddy. I'm going to give you some time to get... Donny's a big man, so he's got to get out of that little car. It's going to take him some time.
Cheers, man. Thanks, Melvin.
Okay, boys, sorry, I've quickly got to run downstairs, but just a quick thing on the track itself. You don't really catch it on the screen unless you go in car. And that's where Peter got it brilliantly right. This track is not a perfect oval. And it does tend to bite you a bit. And also, if you go onto main straight, it's got heaps and heaps of bumps. And especially in these oval cars, you've literally got to gradually get onto the power. And I was watching the stream and trying to follow you guys, and you can see it's catching up, people. People got that bumps in so good.
And also the main straight, Melvin, it's an uphill. It's not a flat piece of tar.
No, it's an uphill, and the back straight is a downhill.
Yeah, so you, the one side you're faster than the other one, but it's brilliant. I've never been to Tony Rust. I've never been to Namibia, for that matter. And just driving Tony Rust on the sim, it does make me feel that when I ever have the privilege to go there, I need to go around that track, because just to the nostalgia that's associated with Tony Rust, I think is just magic.
Sure, you and I can take holiday in December, then we can go and take the bicycles around the track, because I think that might be the only way that we'll be able to go around the track.
Tommy, I'll still fall on the bicycle. A CCB corner will have me writing my name on one of those tire barriers at the end.
Well, just, boys, I'm going to run down quick. I see the server is open, so you guys can start loading in.
Perfect.
At this stage, having a quick look, I see Tanis Basson, Jason Nell, Jay De Villiers, Matthew from the Merva, Mornay Ploy, Stephen Sparks, Warwick Stewart in there as well. I thought he didn't enter, but should be a very interesting race.
Definitely, Melvin. And yeah, run quickly downstairs, but come back. Don't break a leg.
I will see you in 2 minutes.
Let's see if that commentator curse works. That's why we are friends. That's why
we hope not. Melvin has had a bit of bad luck the last bit. I mean, hardware crash on the steering wheel, PC giving a bit of problems. So let's not give him more of a curse and have him fall down the stairs and injure himself. I mean, that will just, no, it's not gonna work.
But it's funny, Tommy, I mean, you and I have never met. We've seen each other on some pictures of Facebook profiles, but neither have you met. I've met Warwick and before and that, but we're like family, we're like friends, we know each other forever, because we spend so much time in an online community together. Just brilliant.
You know, Charles, I have to agree with you on that. I mean, everyone in the sim racing world, we know each other online, we know each other through Discord, WhatsApp, social media, but there's very little people in our group that we have actually met in person. Yes, there's a few people that has met someone that's part of the group, but other than that, we don't know each other personally, face to face. But it's more of a family in SRA than what it is online racing. You personally know the people, what they do for a living, where they live, you know, all of those things. And sim racing is a lot more than just sim racing. You become part of a group, you become part of a family. And that is one of the main reasons why I got involved into sim racing. And what I love about sim racing is the fact that everyone is like family.
Yeah, and you bite each other and you support each other and you play, and it's just brilliant. You know, you can't fault them at all. So yeah, guys, if anybody has done that, just join. If anybody thought that a computer game, as you want to call it, does not make your nerves and your heart beat and your palms sweat, try online racing in a circuit race with 30 or 40 cars. It's not, well, it is humiliating. It's not something easy. It's really intimidating as well.
You know, Charles, I don't know if you ever had the opportunity to actually take a racing car out on a track, or anyone that actually knows sports, that knows that feeling before the match starts or the race starts. Let's take a simple example. All of us know how it feels to just have a little bit of a dice with someone in the streets. You pull up to a car next to you at a robot, and you sit there and you know you're going to do this, and your stomach starts turning and your legs start shaking. You get that adrenaline rush that just runs through your body. And it's exactly the same feeling you get in sim racing when you sit in your seat and you know the race is about to start. It's indescribable, that feeling that you get. It's like sitting in the real thing. It's just indescribable.
No, it is. It's really one of those cases of getting the nerves up, and yeah, it's something to experience. But Yeah, let's see. We've got 40 odd seconds to go in this quali 2. We've got 5 no pitches, I think it is here. Donovan Foster, DJ Rasmus, Monet Deploy, Dylan Fasaghi, and Ronan. I don't see them on the server currently. So, although Monet is actually sitting in the Discord, so I'm not sure where he is. He might join a bit later on. But Hannes Besson and Jay Craig, Steven Sparks, Jay De Villiers, Matthew van der Maven, one of the brilliant cars, I think, in livery wise, all on land as we're getting ready for this one to go.
So I remember some of the cars is actually starting out of the actual pits. So in the race start, you've got some cars on the grid and you've got some cars that's in the or in the pits. So once the green lights go,
oh, there's an accident.
That's why they keep standing still on the track, so that they can actually come in from the pit side and then regain onto the track, and then they start the race.
Yeah, Steven Sparks had a altercation there on the first corner, and that has now dropped him all the way from second into sixth and into last position with quite a huge gap between them all. Hannes Besson now in first position, and then there is a nice race bringing it at the back. Look at Jason Craig. He is hard under pressure from Monet Deploy, who's joined the race, as we said. Just now his car didn't show up. So big battles now in the front. Matthew is now breaking leads in this brilliantly emerald auto body car. And yeah, Hannes Besson still leading the pack.
Yeah, Charles, that top corner as you go out, as you exit onto the back straight, the car does seem to get a bit light on you, and it is a tricky corner there. So the elevation changes again on this track makes it extremely difficult to set up the car properly, and you've really got to adapt every single lap that you go around the track.
Yeah, I'm just trying because I see it is the infamous Tony Rust here with our actual timing board that we only got 4 names showing out of the total 6, so we apologize for that, but we'll definitely try and get that sorted out or see what is the problem. But now we've got Hannes Besson under huge pressure here from Matthew van der Merwe as he's coming up right behind Manners, smelling those bumpers as he's going through. And let's see what is these guys' speeds they're doing. They should probably push around about 100-110, I think, guys.
I think it might be a bit faster than that, eh?
Yeah, let's have a look. Let's swap it over. Oh, wrong swap. Wrong swap. Sorry, apologies. That was a wrong swap. But anyway, so here we go. Out into Main Street. Let's see Hannes Besson pushing at 138 k's an hour as he was going through and trying to get away from Matthew. Matthew doesn't let him go, and he's right over him. And Matthew, I think, is in an Opel Tigra here. So we've got Opel Corsa versus a Tigra. Then we've got Mornay still battling very hard with Jay De Villiers. These two keep swapping positions, and there is a bad lag spike from my side. I can see that now. So technology always happens.
Strange thing, Charles, saying that, talking about the cars and everything. Actually, these cars are all designed to be the same, but for some reason, they all have different characteristics.
Yeah, we saw that in the first corner. Now we had Matthew and Hannes that had a touch, which made them drift almost 90 degrees out, and that has led Jason into the runnings as well. And one lap to go, there is hard pressure onto Hannes. Matthew almost coming in on every corner. Matthew going off track there, and that has pushed Jason right in. I think Jason's going to do this. Jason's coming out right in front. That is Jason there grabbing into that second position. So what a finish to this race. Matthew unfortunately losing there, and Jason capitalizing the most out of this. So yeah, my supporter, my Matthew, he didn't win, but congrats to the other guys. That was a good race.
Now, Jason keeping his head there, and I'm trying to catch you on the stream. So it's Matthew actually won it, or not sure yet?
Yep, no, Jason got a bit there, so...
He got it.
Yep, that was such a good move on him, and he's done it through. Apologies, Tommy, I see I didn't give you something to watch at.
Yeah, Tommy's actually the commentator, and I'm getting so excited I'm taking over here.
No, Melvin, we are all three into this, you help us out, we help you out, we like having you here, we like having you chat to us. And speaking about that, you are from Namibia, and you raced on many occasions on Tony Rust on the main circuit, as well as the oval, and then also rally. Tell us a bit more about the history around the track and where it all started, and just a bit of your personal racing history.
Malvin is the infamous Porsche killer.
Well, basically, Tony Rust, dad of well-known Michael Rust, who races with us on a regular basis, he went into the hills and said, okay, I'm going to build a track here. And everybody was like, what the hell? And he did it. He pulled it off. And we have had numerous South African drivers in Namibia. They all love the track. Actually, the track is driven the other way around now. And it is much more of a driver track than a power track, as opposed to what it used to be.
When we spoke to Mr. Rust earlier, late last year, Melvin, and it was quite, sometimes I think about this and I laugh, because he said to us when he came out to buy the track, or to build the track, he went into the bush there and he saw these hills, and he said to the other guys, I'm going to take that bulldozer and I'm going to build a track here. And they said to him, mach jetzt mal, you know, you're crazy. And he did it. So
he probably built one of the best tracks, I think, in Southern Africa, if not the best. The elevation changes, it's bumpy, it's tricky, there's no runoffs, it's scary, it's one hell of a track to drive on. And having driven there several laps on it, I can assure you, anybody who is a race driver, if you can't race it in real life, try it on the summit. It is as close as you've got to get. We did the Genetas on it last weekend. And I can assure you that it felt real. It felt real. I mean, the next day my wheel broke because of that. It is a car breaker. It is a ego breaker, but it's a bloody nice track to drive on.
Yeah, and you know, Melvin, it's something that's been there for so long. You know, it's part of what you guys are and what you guys has done. It's not like new. And I mean, if you have a look at Tony Rust, it's a fast track. It's definitely not one of our, I mean, if you look at the screen here, I'll show you guys, basically Tony Rust racetrack, 2.6 kilometers long, 5 corners only. And we know, like, if you go into the dip, that is really quite a big elevation change to get into the dip and out of the dip. So, okay. So it is a fast track. It's definitely a great. It now belongs to the Windhoek Motor Club, and they've built it in 1984. And I think recently, about 6 years ago, I think they said that they given them $500,000 to actually revamp it and make it a bit of a safer or a better track. So it's definitely something that's come quite a while.
Yeah, the years of wear and tear has worn away the surface a bit. So the guys are working 24/7 to try and revamp it, and they're getting there. I mean, the track as from where it was a couple of years back to where it is now, it's gone through some massive changes. And as I said, it's a fantastic track, and to have it on the sim is absolutely fantastic.
What is your best corner? What's the one you like the most?
The dip.
I must admit, I do quite like CCB for some reason. I just enjoy that one. And a difficult one is corner one. If you drive it anti-clockwise, the one we're actually viewing now, that is also, because you run it wide, you actually overshoot that little split it makes. So it's a fun track.
It's bumpy. That corner is extremely bumpy.
Sorry to interrupt you guys, but I see we're back on the grid for the next race. And in this race, we'll be having Blake Kruger, Conrad Jansen van Rensburg, Danny van Rooyen, Dennis Knutse, Jason Loosmoor, Jay de Villiers, Matthew van der Merwe, Morne de Plooy, and Steven Sparks. That's on the grid.
Oh, if I have to put my money on, I like to do this. I really like to do this, because if you have a look at these qualifyings, Donny is actually starting here, right in the mid-back of this battle. and almost at the back, and Steven Sparks and Jada Villiers is more towards the front. So we're going to have some faster guys that needs to come through this pack and split them. It's going to make for some interesting racing.
Sure, if you don't mind, can you please share your screen with me?
No, I don't. I do mind.
Anyway, guys, we've got Jason in here, the winner of the previous race. Jason, that was a lucky one. From third to first in two laps.
I mean, didn't I come second there?
No, you won it.
No, Jason did. He jumped it right on the end. He actually got it over from Matthew.
But that was second place because Arnas was first.
That's it. Yeah, correct.
Yeah, lekker. It was awesome.
How was that last corner?
Yeah, look, when I saw the arging and barging there today, he has my chance now. So I had to take it. But I must say to rookie to this competition, yeah, I'm actually starting to like it. And I mean, I think this is my first time I'm doing laps on this circuit and with this car.
Well, doing good. You're going to get up. If you go like this, you're going to get into the fast guys like Dani and Peter Geldenhuis and them. I haven't seen Peter race, but he is pretty quick on the ovals. And Peter Grobler also. Grobby's running this series, putting everything together. Special thanks to him. So, Jason, have fun. We're going to put you back to your pit box and enjoy it, buddy.
Like, thanks, man. Like I said in the chat when I started, we're not here to take part. We're here to take over.
I like that.
Shot, guys.
Cheers, bud.
Enjoy, mate.
Melvin, I think we found a new slogan when we race that we can brand all of our SRA cars with. We're not here to have fun, we're here to take over. That's brilliant.
Well, I have to mention this, and I hope I'm not going to cause any trouble. Ooh. But SRA is actually competing in SRSA's leagues as a team to see how we actually match up against some of their drivers and things. And at the moment, we've got a few guys that's racing in Division 1, but coming tomorrow night, we've got, what, number 9, 10 drivers that's in Division 2. That's literally half of the pack or the field that's out on the track, and it's just SRA members.
Cool. Yeah, I wouldn't brag too much because we didn't make Division 1. Yeah, but it's really great to be 10 cars out of 22 in the division. Yeah.
All right, guys, there we've got lights on here for this first race of the heat. My car off the track and back onto the race. Jada Villiers now already been overtaken by Steven Sparks, who's now breaking away here. Dennis Knutzer is hard on them. Big touch here. We've got touch. But look at this. This is a race like we predicted. Jada Villiers just swung out there. He's hit, I think it was Conrad, on the edge there. And Donnie trying to stick through.
Have a look at Donnie.
Oh, Donnie is trying to sneak through as well there. A lot of touching are going. There's another big touch from Jason Luzmore. And ugliness all over the show here tonight.
You can see Donnie's. I mean, for those who know him and those who don't know him, Donnie's an actual sprint car racer. And working his way through traffic is what he does best.
Oh, big touches there again. We've got the two Corsas, Jada Villiers, and we've got Monet all into that last corner, into a touch. But that was a lot of bumping and bruising between those cars. So there we go. Also, Steven Sparks just spun out. And that's the problem with oval track. You spin out, you lose big.
Yeah, that is very true what you're saying, Charles. And the track is narrow. There's a lot of cars. So the gap is very small. If you make one small mistake, you're going to lose a few positions out there.
Unfortunately, it does happen. Like we said, the qualifying rounds is normally a quiet round. But now when we get into the heat, you can start seeing these guys are staying serious. And that is where I don't want to say the ugliness, but it does happen. You know, tempers flare up and it's just misjudgment. I mean, you don't have peripheral vision. You're in a sim. So you don't have that 360 view. The guys must keep that as well.
Looking at the Tigra, it's a car that I personally don't like at all.
If
you look at Donnie, he is working really hard to try and get past him. As I said, an old man in oval racing, he's going to know exactly where to put that Fiesta. He knows this track, he knows the car.
And there he comes there, onto the main street, on the mains. There goes Donnie on the inside. Oh, look at him.
Little touch.
Bit of a defensive there from Donnie as he's closing out, and I think he's just closed Dennis a bit there, saying to you guys, my bumper past yours and I'm pushing out, and there we see Tyres is already taking a knock here from Dennis.
Jason Lewismore, a new member to us, a well-known name in South African racing, he's right up there, he's pushing Donnie really, really hard.
Yep, second race in a row that he's a top runner, Melvin, and we can go to the back now. We see Blake Creer, Matthew van der Merwe is also there, and Jay de Villiers. Those guys had that altercation and they're right in the back of the pack. But now we've got Donnie van Rooyen also overtaking Stephen Sparks already. Stephen being lapped here from Donnie. Let's keep it clean and get through here. Well done for Stephen. That's a gentleman driver and a half there, and he's let Jason and Donnie right through.
Yeah. And that's the main thing when it comes to back markers is...
Oh, well, we've got a nice little battle there between one of
Conrad.
The... Yeah, that's one of the Jason L cars from his group, and the...
big touch! Blake and Conrad just had an altercation there in race one, and that shows you a little bit of a bump on that speed. It just makes you swing off, and look at this now. Conrad's going to lose a lot of positions here.
The track looks wide, and yeah, well, the race is over. We didn't even watch the laps, but...
It's too fast, Melvin. It's too fast. When you see the race is over.
Jason, there we have it from Peter on the chat. Jason Lewismore is actually the Hot Rod champion for 2020.
That's
so
crazy.
That is why he is giving...
We need to actually
a load of
hassle, uphill. He's giving him a load of main straight.
But yeah, no, definitely.
You know what will be interested is to actually have a chat to Jason as well and ask him how does he find the transition between a real oval and virtual oval.
Well, we've got him in here, so if he can unmute his mic, we can actually ask him. He is still muted. Jason, can you hear us? Doesn't seem like. He can hear us, but he doesn't want to talk to us.
There we go.
Jason.
He's talking to me.
You're on the live stream here, buddy. Okay. We just found out you're actually the 2020 Hot Rod Champions. So how's the transition from real life racing into sim racing?
I'm actually a 2019 Hot Rod Champion.
Close enough.
Yeah, we didn't have a championship last year due to COVID. But the transition, you know, it's a lot different. But it's very nice to get used to once you get the setup right. These cars really are nice to drive.
Well, you're right. Donnie is at this stage, he's one of the quickest drivers, and you're right on him. You think you can take the battle to him?
Yeah, Donnie is very quick, actually. I don't know. We'll see. In the last race there, the back markers helped a bit. But we'll see what the final holds.
Well, have fun, buddy, and Osprat later.
Thanks a lot.
Cheers. I don't know if you want to talk to Donnie again quick. I mean, he's screaming at the top. Yeah.
Who do we have in this heat, Tommy?
Well, in this heat, we'll have Hannes Basson, Jason Nau, Leandre Sparks, Martin Meintjes, Morne Deploy, Peter Geldenhuys, and Peter Grobler. And lastly, we've got Rowan Bauer.
Donovan Foster as well. I see he's not pitching up, but he's also there, DJ and Dylan. But fast names in this one.
Geldenhuys and Grobler, the two P's. The two PGs of SRA, these guys are super quick.
I will not put it past Hannes Basson, Melvin. He's fast here. And then we've seen what Jason Craig also did in the previous racing. So, you can't call this one, eh?
Well, to say it this way, Hannes is actually... He also has a very big oval track racing history. His dad used to race
way back when of my stepfather when they were still racing on the Goodwood Oval that used to be in Cape Town, and then they went over to CHD, which is Cape Hell Drivers on Killarney. So he also comes out of a oval track history, and if I'm not mistaken, he's still racing today.
Yeah, so I know Alice, and he's big in iRacing as well on the same things. So it's been a huge change over coming to Assetto, and he's loving it.
No, definitely. I actually had a chat to him a few weeks ago, and we spoke about the history and all that. And he's actually got a few very old photos and things that he sent through of his dad and my stepfather that used to race together. So it's quite interesting to see where the history is from, people coming from, and the transition and the driving styles from real life racing drivers also participating in the sim racing world.
Yeah, it is. And just to quickly update you guys, the next race, so we had Quali 1 and then we got to go, apologies, heat one, and this is heat two, and then from here we're going to go straight into a plate final, because we do not actually have enough guys to battle it out. The names and the times has been made up, so this is going to be a hard race. I can tell you guys that, because these guys, if they want to get into final one and be in the running for that prize money, they have to win here. There's no doubt. Peter Geldenhuys didn't do so well in the first race. He has to perform. Peter Grobler has to get up to the top. So it's going to be a hard race here.
Well, the guys are pushing it now. It's getting to the finals. It's double points. It's tricky. Grobler knows this track really well. Downey has done 4,500 laps. Geldenhuys is always in factor. So it's going to be tough. It's not going to be easy.
Now, like you said, Grobler knows this track very well, but I'm guessing it's because he actually built the track.
I don't know whether Grobler knows it better than Donny after 4,500 laps.
It's also true, yeah.
Alrighty, we've got 50 odd seconds to go, and then we will be in this final race before the plate final and final one. So, interesting one, and I don't know why, but I've got a funny feeling about Leandre. I think he's going to perform a miracle here tonight. I just got a feeling on this guy.
He's quick. He is quick.
Right, there we go. Over. There we go. Live here. 30-odd seconds to go, Tommy. Cars are heating up. You can see these tensions are brewing. The guys are actually revving them quite hard. Flames shooting out all over. I mean, I saw some of these cars. Flames are so high, they're melting the paint on the guy on the left. So, and the guy that's eating the million in the grandstands just had some popcorn in his hand. So anyway, 10 seconds to go. Here we go, Tommy. We've got one light on, two lights, three lights, four, five, six. Oh, and there was a big jump by Hannes. Oh, unfortunately for that.
Oh, that is very unfortunate, because there is unfortunately no
and look at this. There is going to be altercation here, because now they need to get past him, and there's already battles going through. Check at this.
Yeah, well, he's basically lost the battle. He's got to be the
smallest. Oh, now he's just touched there. Leandre just had a huge touch. He spun out. Peter Geldenhuys in first position. He's under big pressure. Martin Mank has had a brilliant start in this Protea car. And then Peter Grobler is putting up the pressure from the real Martin. So, yeah, he's going to have it hard for this whole night.
Martin was practicing all afternoon. He was on the server the whole afternoon. So, he actually knows the track now and he knows the car.
So I also want so much money.
Martin is also one of the new drivers that's part of SRA, isn't he?
And he's an actual oval driver, and he's a quick driver. So, but Geldenhuys, as I said,
big action here.
And he's keeping the gap.
Look at this fight between Rowan and Peter Grobler. Peter is now being under huge pressure. He's coming under the attack from Rowan. Rowan is on the outside. He actually overtaking Peter on the outside of the lap in two laps. So he's fast. That Tigra is moving.
That is not a very easy line to take, that outside line, especially not all with all the bumps that's on the outside.
That is a brilliant drive by Rowan. I have to say that. Outside, and he's taking it. And look at these. These are five cars all together. Look at this view, guys. There we've got five cars. Oh, big touch there. Rowan just had a touch on Martin and made him spin out.
Well, Martin is not going to be happy about
that. Oh, there's another touch. That is Jason on Rowan. I think he just said to Rowan.
Hold on, on Rowan.
Yeah, you're just saying to him, you know what, we touch one, you touch you. But anyway, three guys still in this race. Apologies, there are seven. I see Hannes jumped to the pits, Martin jumped to the pits. There's only a five-way battle.
Yeah, sadly enough, might be some car damage, might be rage, don't know. But you've got to push it, you've got to get the points and get into the finals. So,
yeah.
As I said, Peter Geldenhuis, Peter Grobler, those are the guys that really, really, they are quick, and Geldenhuis especially.
Yeah, and we can see that Geldenhuis now still in first position. Lap number 10 of coming up of 12. Grobler is just 0.2 behind him, 0.7 of a second. Jason is still battling there. And then Leandre is coming under big pressure now with Rowan as Rowan is coming back. I love the livery of that car. Left side, right side, hood and roof. This is going to be brilliant for me. Grobby's now 0.3 of a second to Geldenhuis. Do you think he's going to do it? One lap to go.
He's really pushing that little car so hard. You can see he's gaining on him. And it might just make a move on the next turn.
0.2. One little corner to go. 0.2 of a second. He's going to go. No. Peter Geldenhuis just played that break game there. And he's won it. But what a drive from Peter Grobler to come in second position. And the two Peters again. Hell of a race. Hell of a race.
I love you.
I have to admit, this was definitely a PG race.
Oh, shit. There's some guys didn't know the race finish. But anyway, Jason Craig and Leandre is still at it there. And then Rowan, I think, was a good race. Let's just give him a bit of airtime here. Look at this. Left sole, left side, bonnet F, roof, visor, right side, right sole, wing R1, R2, wing plate, rear wing, rear panel, well, left and right, and rear bumper. Thanks for now.
We know what part is what of the car, you know. No. He just had to give us indication.
I think we put the molds on and not the actual part.
Yeah, I think I do think as well that was a wireframe that we saw there.
Yeah, so true.
But brilliant, I must say, that was a good race. Peter Grobler did so well.
I want to get Peter Geldenhuis in here. I mean, this is an endurance guy that's used to endurances and
doing well.
He's been thrown into SRA, into short sprint races, and now he's killing in levels. Peter, I mean, probably one of the older members, more respected members of SRA. Brilliant, brilliant guy. Brilliant race.
Hello, Melvin. Yes, yeah, that was a quite an interesting one. I just had to defend like crazy because the guys were on my tail the whole time.
It's from endurance racing that you're used to coming to this. It's a huge, huge change, isn't it?
Yeah, I must say, you know, the endurance race, you're looking at consistency. Yeah, you need to be sharp and on it the whole time. So concentration is quite on a different level.
But it's fun.
Great fun. I must say, this is quite something else. And I think all the other team members of my team as well, you know, they take this and they just love it.
Well, I'm glad you guys are enjoying it. Charles, anything from your side?
Yeah, that is correct. Yeah, we are part of the sim racing crew. Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Yeah, I'm actually racing with a setup from Leandre Sparks. He's in the Tigras, so I adapted that setup, and yeah, it's helping me along. Yeah, I think the guys are gunning for me, so I'm trying to get that up there, you know. yeah, I must say I'm a little bit down lately, you know, but I need to get back to on my level of sim racing, so but we'll get there.
Yeah, it's a huge transition going from endurance racing to short sprint races that we're doing, and well, job well done, buddy.
Thank you, guys. Yeah, and thank you for this series. Very fun. Thank you.
Have fun and keep the contact.
Great racing. Yeah. Thank you, guys.
Cheers, man.
Just helping and playing with each other, you know, there's no
Yeah, so you get the politics of and in some writing you don't get that. Everybody just rises with they just wanna have things where you sit with headaches every night and incidents and accidents. Sorry. But in general, between TTSA, SRSA, SRA, the other one you said now, BRI.
BWR, we've got race
face. There's like a friendship bond going on, and everybody just races everybody.
Yeah, and they all help. That's a nice thing. It's not, if you do need something, it won't say, oh, yeah, but you're part of this guy's got to ask them. You know, it's you always want to help each other.
Well, just to give you an idea, about 5 years ago when I started my Xbox, I bought a Logitech for $5,500, which was, it's so expensive. And now we are literally, SRA, Simrace Africa, has started buying up stock and we're selling it to people at an affordable price. We do not make any profit. No. We sold 3 Logitechs today, near brand new, for 3,000 Rand, which is a bargain.
I missed that somewhere, obviously.
You were busy working, but we tend to try and help the guys getting to some racing, get them on a. Peter is working on mods, you're working on the streaming, everybody's doing their part, and we do that part time. So we give our best. If we do make mistakes, yes, it happens. But guys, if you want to join, if you want to race, talk to us. We always have something up for sale. We always have some event going. Go for it.
But that's what it's about. So that's support and that. And I can see I keep getting a server crash here, Melvin. Do you want to maybe just jump over for me, please, to Warwick? Just ask him if there is a problem because I just keep getting an unexpected error here.
If you want to refresh, I'll do that quick.
Yep, thank you. Technology always happens. You normally what will happen to give the guys in the back on the server side, we'll load up all the drivers in the server, and then you just join the server, put in your password, and you can join it. But the setup of the server currently takes one dedicated guy doing it because he has to load up everybody as they go along. And I'm still battling here. I just cannot get into the server for some reason. And like we say, Warwick has to physically load up every driver, connect them up, set up the server, go live, and that gets normally done in about 30 odd seconds. So kudos for him, he's doing quite a good job for us. But then we do have this issues like now where you just cannot log in for some reason.
Yeah, Shal, I kind of got into the back end of the conversation that you and Melvin had now. Like you said, if anyone wants to join sim racing, speak to us, contact us on Facebook or via WhatsApp or join the Discord channel. But when I joined in on the sim racing, I saw a picture of an event that was going on and I tried joining the event, and unfortunately the people wasn't so welcoming. And at the end of the day, Melvin approached me and he told me that I can join SRA, and I joined them, and believe me, I was more in the way on the track than anything else. But after
Sorry, Melvin?
Yeah, just spoke to Jay now. I think my sound is a bit soft if you want to lift that up.
I shall do so.
So to get back to it, I mean, I was basically more in the way on the track than anything else. And Peter helped me out with some coaching, Melvin helped me out, and Warwick, and there's a whole bunch of people that they just welcome you and they make you feel welcome. And they help you to get set up, they help you to get to know the cars, they help you to improve your driving style. I mean, in a lot of places you get that thing for every man for himself, and if you struggle, then it's your own problem. And when it comes to SRA, it's a whole different ball game. There's people helping you if you've got a problem with your PC. There's people helping you if you want to have a skin made. And it's just everywhere where you look, there's always someone willing to help you.
But that's what it's about. Anything in life, it just you have to help each other, and that's how you grow something. So I'm still battling. I see everybody jumps in and out of the server. So I think there might be some error on the back end. It just tells me the track avatar's not correct. So funny, because we've been racing on this track the whole night. But yeah, Blake is in, Pierre Caldenes is in, and then we've got Dennis jump out and Martin jump out. So,
well, shall remember there's a few versions of the track, and especially on the server side. So it might be that they just loaded the wrong track on the server, and if you don't have the correct one loaded on the server, then the people won't be able to join.
Yep, we just got notification here they are battling with our servers to get it up and running on the back end. So guys, I'm just gonna have to listen to Tommy's beautiful voice. For those who don't know, Tommy does sing on cruise ships, and he can entertain you a little bit.
So where do you fall out of that? Well, I'm pretty sure you fell off the horse instead of your wife, because clearly there's some damage there.
Yeah, it's funny. It's funny. But anyway, with that, while we're waiting, let's quickly show the guys at home something about one of our other leagues that we used to run. We ran a very successful BTCC, British Touring Car Championship, on SRA, and this was what happened. Have a look at this.
Yeah.
All right, so Melvin keeps giving us gas in the background. He says, put your voices on, we want to talk. So Melvin, talk.
Yeah, the music, I don't like music. If I listen to music, I go to a soki.
You go to, what's a soki? Tell our viewers in the UK, what is a soki?
I don't know. Something to be a foot. Anyway.
I think I need to put Melvin's webcam on and you can demonstrate the Soki to us.
Nah, everything is challenged here. Everything is set up. Hopefully I'll be back next week. I can't wait to race again, guys. It's so frustrating, but actually I'm loving the commentating. I know my sound is a bit awkward because I've got such a high roof. They forgot to build a room and build a roof, but anyways.
Yeah, Melvin, I had a bit of a chat earlier to Jason, and we were actually having a bit of a laugh about it, because he said it's the first time today that he will be racing ovals. And I remembered my mom told me a while ago when she took my stepfather's car out on the oval track. She said that racing an oval is like doing a waltz. Now, I mean, I'm not sure who doesn't know what a waltz is, but she says you have to basically just count it out. You know, when you dance the waltz, you do 1, 2, 3, and you keep going. And she says the same thing with oval track. You need to do that 1, 2, 3 count, but on 3, you brake. On 1, you accelerate. So we actually had quite a laugh. And now that you mentioned the Soki, I just had to mention that one.
For me, it's like 1, 2, 3, and 4 is
4.
I forgot to take that.
Yo, 1, 2, 3, slap. Boof.
Exactly. It's it all. Okay, guys. So just for those sitting here, listening, watching, we do have a problem with the service. They are busy resetting everything, so it's going to happen if you run multiple servers in one night.
Yeah, I see we servers back up. Let's try and log in.
Yeah, no, they are busy. I'm working. Warwick is running his butt off in the background.
Shame, yeah. No, he's a good oak. He's and I just said earlier. I mean, you know, normally everybody's got a day to set up a server for a race, and he's got to do it in a couple of seconds. So, yeah. And especially with this final, it's not a click of the button, but hey, guess what?
He's got it up.
Let's go see what's happening in the world of waltz.
1, 2, 3, 4.
One, two, three.
No, you've got to remember 4.
Yeah. It's like...
Now I know why Melvin is thinking of the number 4. It's when it comes to the tequilas. It's 1 tequila, 2 tequila, 3 tequila, 4. So I'm guessing he got the dance confused with the tequilas.
Number 4's always been my favorite number.
So and, Tommy, you've built or you've given us this 4 transit that we're in for today for the commentators and the spectator van. How fast is this thing?
I have no idea. Actually, I haven't driven it. This transit...
Okay.
Was built around... There's actually a history behind this transit. And the guys that knows Cape Town racing, that knows the old Tigerberg and Worcester racing, they will know where this transit comes from. There was this old guy. We used to call him Uncle Wally. Now, he used to show up to the track in his transit and... It's a transit that he built from scratch, and it was so suited up. It had a table, it had its own braai, it had all the gizmos and gadgets. I mean, even the seats could rotate to face the back of the bus. And I mean, this is an uncle that we grew up knowing from start of kids and oval track and all those things. And he ended up having a few friends that built their own as well. So at the end of the day, there was like 3 or 4 of them, it was parked next to the track. And when I saw this thing, it just reminded me of Uncle Wally. And I decided it might be a nice idea to actually take this transit and make it the commentators as well as sponsor car. So, yeah, it was purely out of just the memory of Wally that I actually went and did this transit.
Okay, well, if you don't know how fast it is, I'm not jumping out of it. I'm racing this race.
Are you gonna chase the guys down a bit?
Yeah, no, I'll show them what oval racing is.
If you're on your steering wheel, you're welcome to like just, you know, take half a lap behind them and then jump to the pitch just to give them a bit of
no.
Yes, you know, something goes wrong and then I take half of the field and I plate final out. It's gonna be fun and games. I can tell you, these guys will not like me at all.
Well, no, but it might be fun having them live in commentary, hearing what they have to say.
But I just had a look at, you know, guys put effort and they put passion into these cars. I'm just looking quickly at Martin Mankey's car. I mean, this Protea race car that he's done, Martin Mankey's number one car, Peugeot 208 here, and what a nice touch. On the back of his car, he's got Megan, Zandre, and Tanya, which is obviously his wife and kids, or his kids only. It's a nice touch. You know, it's a personal touch, and it shows you that this is more than just racing. It is the family support and friends and the wife support. Because even if you sit in front of the thing, you know, they are still there in the background, so just giving you the time and effort. So it's nice.
Yeah, you know, I actually had the, or I have the privilege of actually speaking to Martin on a regular basis, although it's just on WhatsApp. We actually got to know each other very well, and he is a very big family man. His friends, his family, and his nickname is I think it's Vitter and Noster, but I think it's more like a teddy bear instead of a Noster.
I don't know. There might be a reason why he's called a Noster.
There might be, eh?
But anyway, 20 odd seconds to go in this plate final. We will have Tommy, who's in this race?
Oh, let me just jump in there and quickly.
Blake Creer, Dennis Kutzer, Jada Villiers, Martin Mankey, Peter Geldenhuis, Peter Grobler, Steven Sparks, and well, Warwick is there just for support and running the service. So, again, Geldenhuis, as we saw. New world breaking, always quick, but a bit unpredictable.
Oh, goodness, we're off. Get my camera sorted, asshole. Anyway, we saw now as we broke through, sorry, Melvin, there was already a touch with Peter Geldenhuis right on the front, and he's jumped right to the back of this case. So, yeah, Dennis Knutsen now taking up the lead. Blake Creer is in second position. Jay de Villiers making his place into third, being chased hard by Mr. Vitra Noster himself, and then Marta Mankis. Steven Sparks has joined up there, and there's already a lot of action and passion between Jay de Villiers and Steven Sparks and Martin Mankis, and if these guys carry on the way rubbing each other up, I'm playing Phil Collins later on.
Well, we've lost the live stream, so I'm literally watching the delay of the stream on YouTube, and
apologies, just say sure, do your job. There we go, guys. All right, back to the front. Dennis Knutzer is still in the lead, and he's now actually been under big pressure from Blake. These guys are a couple of seconds from each other, five laps into a 14-lap race, and big fight.
Well, Blake is quick. Blake is pushing it. I think he's got his rhythm, he's got his brandy, he's pushing it.
Yeah, and there was also Marta Mankis and Jay de Villiers are keep on touching each other. I think definitely Phil Collins need to come out and visit a little bit later on. But Steven Sparks is now just settling in. And unfortunately for Peter Geldenhuis, he's right at the back and he's fallen right through. I mean, he's on lap 5 where the other guys are already on lap 7. So he's had a bad one.
From a win to a lose.
It happens. That's what we said.
It's so hectic.
Just one slip of that rear tire on the gravel and you're out. So, Marta Mankis now, Mr. Vitra Noster is now touching up and he's giving Blake a lot of pressure as he's slowly but surely gaining that. And I think Dennis is settling in quite nicely in that lead. 9 laps already done.
Well, the pace is quite consistent. And if you have a look at Blake, it's actually catching up. And as well as Marta Mankis, they are busy closing the gap. And this is going to get quite interesting going down to the final lap or two in the race.
I think Blake is going to settle down. He knows he has to get points to get into the final, although it's Blake. He's gone for it. He's taken the move. He's going on the inside.
Can he make it? There was slight contact between the two.
But he's done it. Blake has done it.
Yes, he's actually up in the lead.
Bumped him out of the way and he's made that one stick. So that Corsa and the Tigra, and what an impressive run by these Tigras. But look at these guys, they are splitting away 5 seconds from the pack. That's the fastest gap, or the biggest gap we've had this whole evening. Jay de Villiers now also under big pressure from Steven Sparks. These guys haven't let each other off this whole race, so there is still a big fight. And then Martin with that big touch. Ooh, that was a big of a lag spike.
I hope it's not, it might be Martin's internet acting up again.
Definitely.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that is Martin's internet that's going on the fritz
again. If you see Route 3, 1 and 2, you can see them because the flames on the side of the car. The 2.1s run with a flame at the back. So Route 3, 1 and 2.
Right, Blake Creer just and took Martin it there. Blake Creer won that race, Dennis Knudsen 2, so it's nice to see two of our new guys that's taking that position. Jay de Villiers in 3rd, Stephen Sparks brings it home there in 4th, Peter Geldenhuys in 5th and Martin Mankies just before the final race disconnected on that. So yeah, up next, a hell of a big fight.
Well, we've got Blakey, the SRA clown, in chat here.
How's it, guys?
Hey, Blakey. How was that for you?
Hey, awesome, eh? Hey. Oh, I outbraked myself a little bit, bumped him there. I felt a bit bad, waited, and he came on in front at least. But just normal driver's etiquette normally if you make a mistake. But always start, always sweating. It's tough, eh? This is my first time in ovals. The setup is completely opposite to normal track racing, but yeah, exactly. Getting used to it and loving it.
You're one of those guys that, like Donnie, you spend hours and hours of practicing.
OCDs.
Setup make a difference.
Absolutely, it's like the real thing. I tell you, I started maybe a year ago, just knowing that put the front shocks harder, it puts more traction on the back, throws the weight back. From there, you into dampers, rebound, anti-roll bars, your tire pressures, you're out by 0.2 PSR, you're 0.2 of a second slower a lap. It's and the best thing is when the fast real life South African real life racing come and join, they're faster than you. That's when you know a game is good and it's realistic.
Nice.
It's also fun, Blake, to see what's happening in sim racing is you'll find that a lot of races you'll actually have sim races and real life races on the same course, and absolutely, you'll find that a lot of sim guys are giving these real races stick, and then you'll find on some other tracks is vice versa and turn around. So it's very even.
Definitely. I mean, the first online South African event I joined, the sim racer, can't remember his name now offhand, he won a fully sponsored Polo Cup car to drive for this year. It would be this year because that was last year. So he's gone from playing computer games to a real life fully sponsored Polo Cup. Yes. So it's excellent. Yeah.
Yeah, it is. And you know, we've got a lot of races that starts off at a young age. We've had, I think at once, Melvin, we had a 9-year-old that was joining us. We've got 14-year-olds, we had some 17s, your son.
Yes,
so
yes.
It's you can't, and you get some fast youngsters and you get some fast old men.
I tell you, there's another Lati, Tyler Stephen, relative of Michael Stephen, and he's races go-karts. He's 7 years old and we within 0.3, 0.4 of a second a lap. I mean, he's still learning how to set up the car. So I don't know what he's going to do in real life once he knows what. Oh, Dad, the front's understeering. Okay, soften the front a bit or whatever, or harden the back, you know. So it really does help real life racing. And yeah, it makes us more visible as sim racers. Some guys are really into that for sponsoring and giving opportunities.
It is, and it's at the end of the day, like we say, it is quite a nice event. And the camaraderie, how did you find joining up a server like, say, SimRace Africa, and the support and the people around you?
No, everybody. So SimRace Africa, I mean, Melvin's from Namibia. We're thousands of kilometers apart. Everybody is here. They're willing to help. You don't just join and you're slow and they leave you because they want to beat you in the race. They will give you their setup. They will tell you, okay, what's the car doing? Oh, I'm losing time in this corner because of the back stepping out. Okay, do this. Change this tire pressure. They're always willing to help. And which is actually a problem because everybody's sharing information and setup and guiding that in the race, it's so tight because the guy that hadn't been given assistance, he might have been way back, but now he's up fighting for third. And then he learns that way. So it's really an awesome.
How much did you pay Melvin? How much are you paying Melvin?
Melvin.
Because he's never shared a setup with me, and he's never, he's keep, I'm the slowest guy on the server, and he keeps me slow.
Is it?
No, he keeps me slow.
Well, I caught him out in one race. He went half a second faster than me after speaking to South African rally champion, Joel Wilken, in real life, as we call it. And I said, Melvin, no ways, but we've done 500 laps on this track. As soon as I saw him in Discord chatting to Joel Wilken, and immediately he was like 0.2 or 0.3 of a second. I said, come. And he gave me a lota. And I went a bit faster. Not as fast. I don't think he shared everything with me, obviously, because it was South African championship related. But yeah, absolutely. It's tight. It's like real life racing. You don't risk your life. If you've got a family, it's a safe way to do the exact same thing, you know.
Well, Blake, if you think of it in this way, I mean, where's the fun in racing on your own? So, I mean, if you share your setup and you have the guy that's right at the back now fighting for third, instead of driving in third on your own, now you've got someone to actually compete with.
That's what it's about. You don't want to be in the front and you pull, you've done it, you know, a couple laps than the other guys. You know the engineering background of the car, what it does, where to fuel, where to set, and then you're driving by yourself in front, you know, a lap ahead or whatever. It's not fun. So the guys are all gentlemen here. If we've got a special app that shows if there's a car next to you, because some of us only have single screens, not virtual reality or triple screens, so we can't see the car next to us. So we've got the app that shows, pops up on your screen if a car is within, let's say, 5 meters or 10 meters, and then you can see the other car next to you and you give him room if, you know, there's room to be given, and it's according to the, what they call it, the race steward law of racing. Yeah, good fun.
Are you finished now? Can we talk?
Okay.
No, I'm joking. We've got 1 minute to go. Blake, lucky to have you with us. And yeah, it's always good to see you online and on WhatsApps and everywhere. And yeah, stay the guy you are.
Good, no problem. Thanks, guys.
Cheers,
all the best.
Mate. Cheers. Bye.
Well, we have it. We have it from the circus clown.
So this is the finals, if I'm not wrong.
That's it. Finals here. Donny van Rooy and Rowan Bauer in second position. We've got Jason Craig, Conrad van Rensburg, Hannes Basson, Rowan Bauer, Donny van Rooy, Leandre Spogs, Jason Loosmoer, Matthew van der Merwe, and Peter Grobler that will take this final into... And yeah, let's see. I think there is big nerves in that one.
I think it's going to be between Donny, Jason Loosmoer and Rowan. These guys are quick. Yeah. They are proper quick.
I would not take Peter out of this fight.
And Matthew.
I think this is going to be maybe a 4 to a 6 way battle for that league.
All right, guys. We've got 4, 5, 6 lights on. And let's see what's going to happen now. Lights off as these guys going on. I just want to get these cars sorted out. And then we go back on track. Donny van Rooy on the lead. Rowan is in second there. And I see in the back, we already got a little bit of a bunch up. Matthew van der Merwe losing out there to Conrad as he's now gone off. But yeah, big battles. Already back a split in three.
Well, Donny seems to be running away with it. He's got that car so dialed in. The longer base face, as they call it. It's so long.
I actually like the look of it, that drop chop top that it's got with the longer wheelbase. I think it actually suits the Fiesta very well.
It looks like a Opel Astra. You used to get those Opel Astras that's like long and the long lights. But anyway, going back now, check Matthew onto Conrad on the outside. Matthew in the Emerald Auto Bodies car now on the back straight, touching. You can actually see Conrad pushing into Matthew. But Matthew regained that one. And he's getting through at the back now. Hannes Basson under big pressure here from Craig, as Hannes is now trying to make his way onto Conrad as well into the main straight. So, yeah, big battles brewing, and you can't call this. Jason Loosmoer, look at him. Onto Rowan. Third position is up. There he goes into second. Let's see if he's going to make this stick. Very close. These guys, let's see actually this rash action, how close these guys are when they go into this corner, Melvin. This is going to be touching each other. Look at this bumpers.
It's two Tigras, and I mean, these Tigras have seemed to be pretty quick. As I said, all these cars seem to be the same, but...
Now you're going to see here, also Jason's going to try and split Harness and Rowan as they go through the lap. So, yeah, There's big action here. Leandro Sparks has joined that battle here, also in the cars. And Donnie is sort of running. Oh, there was a big touch. I think it was a bit of a break there. And Jason just went right into the back of him. 9 laps out of the 14. Donnie is running away with this Fiesta. He's getting it through. Peter Grobler is taking up that second position, so that's 10 points, 9 points, and then we've got Jason Lausmer. He's joined up in third still, and you can see him actually giving that positions back to Rowan, so I think he's also...
He's pushing hard now, eh?
Yeah.
He is pushing hard now.
Conrad is still in the race there.
I have to say, hats off there to Matthew for actually throwing away his entire race, but he waited for Rowan to give him back that position.
No, it's actually Jason that dropped down to wait for Rowan to come past. Matthew is still running in third position. Yeah. So it is, but that's gentleman's racing and fair pass policy. You know, if it's your accident that you caused, then guess what? You give the position back. Even if that guy ended up lost, you're going to be lost. So that's what it's about. So yeah, nice. Donnie van Rooyen now, look at him. 10 seconds lap is building up onto Peter Grobler. That is just crazy. It's like nobody is in this race even.
I think the Fiesta is getting a white penalty next race.
you cap him on only 10 practice laps. He doesn't need it. So anyway, on the final now, let's give Donnie a little bit of excitement as he's bringing it on to the final corner. And Donnie, flashing your lights. And Donnie's just taken this one. Brilliant race from you. Peter Grobler is bringing it home at third. Matthew third. Conrad. And look at this race. Conrad is still out. Oh, he's almost going to go spinning over. Look at that. That was such a finish. But guys, look at these times. Let's see if we can see these times. Look at this. We've got Jason Craig at 341.012. Jason Lewismo at 341.052. 341.2, 342. So it's like point one, not even 0.1 second between these guys as they cross that line.
That was exceptionally well. Close racing, hard racing. We knew this was going to happen in ovals, and it usually does. I need to get Mr. Danny Faroyan in here. We need to tell him he's going to get his car impounded.
Yeah, you're going to tell him that he's not too fast. No, but what a race. What a race.
But yeah, 4,500 laps. It did work. It helped. Danny, what the hell?
What's wrong, Melvin?
I know you get the giggle and what's wrong.
But no, it's you, the car.
You put in the time, you get the results, eh?
10 Danny, seconds.
We've seen you on every single server. Whether it's track racing, whether it's oval racing, no matter what, you sit for hours and hours. Your wife has called us, telling us to ban you, and you've got the results tonight. First overall, won every single heat. The car seems to be dialed in perfectly. This track is not an easy track.
No, it's a bit bumpy.
You're going to have to change the setup for the next one, or you're going to ride like it?
I'm going to change the setup. We played a lot with the ARBs to get over those bumps. So hopefully the rest of the tracks or the other tracks hasn't got all those bumps. So we can change the ARB so the car can settle down a bit.
Coming from real racing, going into the sim racing world, it's a thing we've been talking about all night. Is it as close as you can get on IC?
Definitely. This is as close as you can get to the real racing.
I mean,
say again. Oh, yes, definitely. Yeah, look, the adrenaline was pumping that first race. Eh? Yeah, it was really difficult.
Well, darling,
we calmed down a bit, but it was still hectic, the nerves. Eh?
We're amazed on the second heat you went out. You started 7th or 8th and you just came through the field and unbelievable.
I surprised myself there because on oval track there's not really a lot of places to pass the guys. But you just have to be calm and collected and wait for your spaces to go open and you go through.
Well, Danny, well done. First overall for the evening. Unbelievable. We predicted it. And that Ford is fast.
Thanks a lot, Melvin.
All right. Well,
thank you.
Cheers, man.
Bye-bye.
So, boys, there we have it. I've taken over the stream with a cuck of sound around here.
Well, you can say hi to our viewers.
Chris, I mean, you've sat hours and hours on end, and you've sorted this, and we had one hell of a race tonight. I think everybody who watched it would love it. If they don't, wrong place.
They're definitely missing out if they don't watch the stream.
You're on a wheel, on a new wheel, actually, and does it make a difference on the ovals?
Hello.
Yes. Did you hear
me? Sorry, man. I'm checking the stream here, so sorry for that, man.
Okay, that wheel that you've got now, does it make a difference? Let's start there.
It makes a huge difference. It's much more direct. You can have more constant and more consistent laps, and the feel of the track is more clear. So you know exactly what you do. But it's still, the oval is still something else. Sometimes it's a bit more or too sensitive for me, so I'll still have to make a few adjustments so it can suit my driving style.
Well, you built these cars as close to the real thing you could, and the tracks is absolutely phenomenal. Quick question: as from an admin side, you had your hands full tonight with Warwick, with everybody pitching in. You weren't able to concentrate fully on your racing.
Yeah, it's difficult to race during, if you're admin as well, and if you are running the server. But I must take my hat off to every admin here. Everything went smooth. There was a few hiccups, but I always say it's the hiccups, how you resolve it, that makes you. So if there's some mistakes or some errors, we quickly fixed it. And like I've said, hats off to Warwick. He's in the background. You don't hear much about him, but he did a very sterling job.
I think from our side, from Simrace Africa, the first stream we had in months, I think we got I hope we got everything right. And guys, we'll be back on Thursday, I hope. I'm going to talk to Charles. We've got the genetics. Hopefully, maybe. I mean, it for me, it's a big thing. It's East London. Peter, you designed the track. It is a first on AC. It is a first on sim racing in Africa. The actual East London track converted from RFT, if I believe.
Yes.
It's as close as you can get it. You put in hours and hours upon end of it. So I hope we can stream that one. I'm going to try our best. I'm going to plead with Shaw to do that one for us. If I'm not up and running, I'll definitely be commentating. But watching those genetics, from what we saw tonight, was close, quick racing. It was absolutely fantastic. Going to the Genetas, close racing, but still they seem to be a lot more drivable.
Yeah, they are a lot more forgivable.
Yeah, and I think we're going now from a quick races to a type of an endurance race, so that will be a whole different ball game.
Well, Peter, you had the thing dialed in perfectly tonight. You had everything in place. Well done, buddy. I'm going to hand it over to Shaw. I've taken over the stream, sort of.
That's fine. Well, and with that now, provisional results is in already. That is how sharp our admin team are in the background. And if you guys have a look on the screen, let me just grab this one and show you the right screen as we go along. Yeah,
that'll be Warwick.
Yeah, it's one of those. Let me just see if I can grab that screen for you. Just got to get this thing up and running. Sorry for that. But provisional results now are actually standing on Donnie van Rooyen, let me just grab it. 2 seconds. There we go. I just had to change that. There we go. Donnie van Rooyen from Maximum Effort is now taking 49 points after round one. Peter Grobler, Grobby's Jack Tool Racing in 35 points. DeAndre Sparks, brilliant driving in 34. So him and Peter is only 1 point difference. Jason Lewisma also really nice in 33 points. Tight with Jason Craig there as well in 33. Matthew van der Merwe brings it home in 31. Rowan Bauer in 30 points. Then we've got a tie there between Conrad van Rensburg and Hannes Basson, 8 and 9 on 26 points. Dennis Knutsen in 22. Blake Creer in 20. Jay de Villiers in 19. Peter Geldenhuis in 17. Steven Sparks in 16. Martin Menkes 12. Mornay Duploy is bringing it home in 7. But just remember, he hasn't had a full race.
Charles, looking at Leandre, he had a couple of off moments and he was consistent. He kept on racing. He just kept on pushing. Same with Peter.
Yep.
And they've got the points racking. Donnie is going to be the guy to catch in the series. And I think tune in next week, boys. It's going to be epic. Believe me, this is going to get... Terry Russ was tricky. Now we're going to the flame tracks. They go fast. Believe me, they do go fast.
Next track up, Alvin, do you know?
Not sure, actually.
I'll just quickly check here.
Skilani?
That's it. 16 February. Joining us in Kilani there. It's going to be an interesting while as well. In Cape Town, some of the homeboys will be there.
I love that track. We know that. An absolute epic track.
Oh, we know that. We drive it every night. But in anyway, from us here, Simrace Africa, guys, thanks for joining us. It was really lucky to be with you guys again. And let's see what happens next time.
Yeah. Shall just word out, you've got a better voice than me. If the guys want to join, search Simrace Africa on Facebook.
That's it. Simrace Africa. Join us on our Facebook channel, join us in our YouTube channel. And you'll be always, know what's going on and what's happening in the light and the life of sim racing. So, Melvin,
if you want to get involved and not involved yet, we'll help you.
That's perfect. So, Peter Warwick from my side, thanks, guys. We appreciate you all. Jay on the background, keeping us on the straight and narrow. You're also there, Melvin. You're always a real start marker. So let's hope for that. And then Tommy with a beautiful voice from the cruise ship. Let's do this next time.
Yeah, definitely up for the next race.
Cool.
Thank you, Alvin. Was fun having you guys off. I'm actually being able to be with you guys in the commentating booth.
No problem.
Can't wait for next week.
Cool, guys. Then from Simrace Africa side, keep safe, keep well, and stay safe this week. Let's not hope we will get washed away too much. Cheers. God bless. Bye-bye.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.